Hello and welcome back to some evolving technology. Welcome back, guys. It's been a while since I've actually played this mod pack. Last two series kind of went stumbled and followed because things kind of went wrong with the game itself and all that type of stuff. So we are back into trying to do the series. This thing is about evolving through the technological age of what we ourselves have gone through and will be probably going through, and it's just a Minecraft version of that. So I hope you guys enjoy this. You can find this on the Cursed Voice Launcher and possibly FTB. I don't know, probably not, but I'm playing this on the Voice Curse, so go check it out. It's a pretty good mod pack. Hopefully it's even better since it's been updated and stuff. Anyway, guys, I will see you in the game and we'll discuss more from there. But yes, as I said, welcome back to some evolving technology. So as you can tell, we spawned into a lovely jungle. I'm going to get out of this as fast as possible because it is super laggy, of course, and there's not much we can do until we get out of this because, yeah. So the last two series that I've done, whoa, that was a very bad grammar. they stumbled and fell. The first one failed because the world was going to get corrupted by the update and we would have to restart the whole thing. So I restarted from there. And then the last one I did, it failed because just a lot of things were wrong, that bugged up and just kind of wrong. So I didn't finish it, and it was just kind of, it was getting a little whacked up for me, so I decided to just kind of stop it. But a lot of things have updated and stuff like that, so I've decided to try it again, and hopefully we go. I was going to do a collab with it, but my friend is busy and stuff with that, with work and everything. So I've decided to do this one by myself because I actually want to do it and stuff. But the Project Ozone, by the way, guys, I have privated the series, so you guys can't watch it, and I'm pretty sure I'm probably going to be deleting it, because it's not a mod pack that I really wanted to play. I don't know why I started it. It looked kind of cool. It had a HQM mod in there and stuff like that. This isn't breaking, whatever. But it looked kind of cool to begin with, but it just, as I progressed in it, I got more bored of it, and it didn't go well for me. And whenever something doesn't go well for me myself, it won't translate very well in the series. And I want the series to be as best as possible for you guys to view and for me to play. That way it can be amazingly beautiful and lovely, brilliant thing. That was a very long description for no reason. But anyway, guys, as we get back into the mod pack, you'll see we have some seeds over there. Lovely. This will help with the hunger overhaul that we have and Pam's Harvest Craft, which adds quite a few things of food and stuff, which I'm pretty sure this actually... One thing I don't like about... I think it's Hunger Overhaul or something like that. One of those mods for hunger is with the food types, it's... tends to be stupid, as in you have to eat a variety of things, so that's a tad bit annoying, but we will work through that. By the way, guys, I am on my PC. I am not on my laptop, thank goodness. I know the first series I did, and I think maybe second that I did on it, I was on my laptop and it was very laggy and all that type of stuff, but this time I am not on the laptop, I am on my PC, so it's going to go very well. Okay, so we have vines. That is a good thing. And I need to have... I'll stick near the jungle. That way I can grab the vines. If you do not know, and I don't know if the recipe has changed or not, but if you didn't know, vines are helpful to get a shooting like moss or something. I don't know what it's called, but it's like a ball of moss type thing that you shoot at cobblestone. And that generates... mossy cobblestone, which will help you get auto repair. I don't know if in this we have people, but I don't know in this if we have thermal expansion. I don't know if we do, but in thermal expansion, you can add energy cells to your tools and use energy as a health bar, durability bar, whatever it's called. But I don't know if we have that in here. I think we do, so that will be helpful. But at the beginning, I usually use ball of moss because it's under repair and I don't have to continually use tools. materials to use the tools. Anyways, I'm going to collect some things and get some things going, and then I will be right back whenever we are ready to start making some other things and doing other stuff. So, I guess I'll be seeing you guys in a little bit. Okay, so I'm not too sure on how much I'm going to get in depth with actually the tutorialness of this. I know the other couple tutorials I've done, what is going on with the King Slime? Why is he dying? But I know on the other ones I have gotten really in depth on how to do stuff. I'm not too sure on how much I'm going to do that with this, but I guess we'll see. Anyways, need to grab some patterns. We really need to get inside before we start to... Why is the King Slime dying? I don't understand. I think I'll do it right here. This is where my home is going to be. And as usual, I'm going to be underground. So let's grab a workbench, of course. And let's also grab the other things that we're going to need for getting with Tinker's Construct. All right, so we're going to want the tool station. All these books that I don't want. We're going to need a stencil table. Whoops, wrong thing. It's getting pretty dark. I need to get stuff going. And you. I'll get the pattern chest here soon. But I need to start getting inside. So, there we go. Let's put these down. Doesn't really matter what order I do it in right now. Let's just do a pickaxe, and then we'll do everything else later. But we'll grab these. And what I usually do is I usually use flint, and that's how you make flint for the first tools. So not doing a very good explanation, but that's because I need to get inside. This uses half, which a stick is half. I would use a stick and not a plank because it's you can get four of them, and it uses two for some reason. And the explanation is a little bit weird, but it's just more efficient for you to use a stick instead of a plank. Just put it that way. All right, there we go. Let's get the pick, and let's get inside before we get eaten. Sheep, no offense, but you're in the way. So, bud, if you don't move, thank you. You're about to die. All right, so, and if I were you, I would keep all the books that you get while you spawn, because you're going to need them as you move along in the mod pack. All right, here we go. This is going to be the starting of our house. As usual, I do a underground house most of the time. If I want to get really special, I can do a above ground, but right now, we're just going to stick with the underground because there's going to be quite a few things that we want to do with this type of stuff. So, time for mining. Alright, I'm just going to grab these. There we go. Let's block off the entrance here. Hopefully there's no baby zombies. That was a whoops. Didn't mean to do that. Alright, there we go. And then I usually try to do a three here. This is the tutorial on how to build a house. No, I need to get going with this. All right, there's that. Let's also grab some coal. Wait, I need to upgrade my picks before I can do that. Let's start mining down. Here we go. All right, so what I'm going to do is let's just do it up here. Got a lot of copper. That's a good start. Very, very good start. I also need to grab that aluminum gravel that's out there because of stuff. We also want to eat. Hunger is a very, very big deal in this mod pack, so be careful of that. All right, let's grab a furnace. And there we go. And then leave that in there for whenever we grab that. We're going to mine a little bit because I need to get this leveled up. Tool progression in this is a little bit tricky. If you want to, you can follow me along with how I progress my tools, and that will get you up to being able to get alumite, and then depending on the thermodynamics, I'll probably do an enderium later on. But if you don't want to have to worry about trying to figure out what tools to how to progress and everything, just follow along with how I do it, because I will tell you how I usually progress it. And you can go along from there, but if not, you can just look around to see what mines what and what can be upgraded. Each tool you upgrade can upgrade to one higher, so just keep that in mind. But as I said, if you want to, just follow along, and you'll see how to go from there. Sorry, it's a little bit dark. I need this to level up, that way I can get it going. I need the coal. Give me the coal. Also, by the way, if you don't understand what means leveling up, this is a lovely thing. We are mining level of stone, which is what we're mining right now. The mining XP is the leveling up of the how to, like the levels of so much. The skills is when skills are basically whatever modifiers you want to put on there. So with iguana tweaks, as you skill up, it will add modifiers on there without you having to add them. So it's a nice little thing where you don't have to add lapis or anything. It'll automatically add it on there. Though it is random, but it's still, yeah, still pretty cool. So just an FYI. Especially with something that's harder to try to obtain, it's better to try to leave it at luck. Being out, not lapis luck, but try to leave it at randomized. And hopefully you get something good. I think I'm not going to get this. So I think I'm just going to chuck in. Why is that? Oh, it just looks light outside. I think I'm just going to chuck one of you in here. Just so I can get some light in here. Alright. Got to keep mining. And then I need to get more gravel. Which gravel here. Nice. Nice that I'm getting gravel here. But I usually do, because I need food. I usually do a mattock, a axe, shovel, and the pickaxe. I don't do a sword because you can use the other tools for that, and there's no point of wasting it until I'm pretty sure I'm probably gonna do a crossbow probably on here. So I don't usually use a sword hardly ever, unless if it's a bound sword and that's magic, and this doesn't have magic, I don't believe, in it. So also, to be able to progress in this, use the progression book. If you don't have one, it should spawn with you all the time, but if you don't, just if I can spell, hello, progression book right here. You probably can't. Well, that's very helpful. Cool. So, if you can't, you spawn in like this. If you don't have this, just go options, inventory, hit make this to world, go to cheat mode, get back out of that. This puts you up to here, and you can go into whatever you want over here. But you get to this, and you can right click, and look, voila. So, that's how you do that if you forget how to do it. And I guess this is all the progression type stuff. And to be able to make the one thing I don't like about this, one thing I like about mod packs, well, most mod packs, is that you can make an item whenever you want. One thing I don't like about the progression is you have to unlock the item to be able to make the item. So there's some things in here that I like to do before anything else, but with this I can't do it because it's not locked. Well, because it is locked. Alright, so, I usually put torches here. Also, that's probably a rogue android, but, well, we won't look at it today. They're very mean, so just be careful of those. Alright, let's grab another flint, because I need to upgrade, I need to repair it. Cool little thing about iguana's tweaks is that you can put it in your little crafting inventory here, and it will upgrade with it. Normal Tinker's Construct, you can't. You have to go with the tool station. So, just an FYI. But with this mod pack, you can. Right, I think I'll go maybe this far. And then this is going to be the beginning of... Hello, zombie. This is going to be... Alright, so this is going to be stairs. I need to go one more in. And this is going to be the beginning of the platform for my house. Pretty good. Alright, now that I have some torches, I'm going to start making some things. I think I'll do it down here, though. Alright, 3. Yes, zombie, what do you want? Alright, let's do it right here. Alright, so we want the tool station, we want the stencil, and part builder. Also, while we have the crafting bench up here, we should make a yule, which means we can now make the patterns chest. And the cool thing about patterns chest, if you don't know, is that whatever you put in here, you can break this and it'll keep it in there. So, cool little thing, if you have a whole bunch of patterns that you're trying to lug around, I would put it in a pattern chest, and you only have to use one slot instead of the 10 that you were trying to use. So, there you go. Alright, so what we're going to want to do is go into the stencil table, throw these in here, and we're going to want to make the axe head and the shovel. This is the only ones you need to make at the very beginning, because it will, that's basically all you need. So you're going to want two for now. Let's grab some more of you. I think it's becoming daytime. We need to go outside and grab some more stuff. But at the moment, let's grab these, and let's go into here. Regular sticks you can use as tool rods, which is pretty cool. So don't waste any of the patterns for a tool rod until you need to make a tool rod. So just hold off on that. Also, one thing, I'm pretty sure we can make a juicer, which basically adds more to what you can make with this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to probably throw you in here. I only need two of those to get cooked up. Actually, I think I need three, possibly. Also, I want to make a door. So let's make that and place it there. All right, there we go. What I'm going to want to do at the moment... Hi, zombie. You're running for your dear life. All right, so I want this, which I can grab good. This will help you... Well, this will help me get some stuff for the tinkers. I'm just going to grab... I'm going to gather some more resources, and then probably once it hits stay time, I will come back and do some more crafting and stuff. So, I'll see you then. Okay, so quick little FYI note here. So, this mod pack has the Battle Gear mod in here, which pretty much accesses... it has weapons and shields and stuff, and you notice the little things over in the corners here, the three bars, those let you put shields and swords in it, and how you access that is hitting R. So yeah, so you can literally just go up to something and just and it accesses both the left and right click buttons, just FYI. Hit R again to get out of it. You can change the hotkeys, but they're set there for a reason, I'm pretty sure, so just keep it there. Anyways, one reason why I'm recording right before anything is I'm about to upgrade this tool, so I want to show you what it looks like. There's usually a ding to it, like that. Emerald is pretty sure a durability thing. Yep. It's there's a difference between the diamond, I think it's diamond, and the emerald one. The diamond just adds, I think, 100 so, and the emerald, or whatever it is, adds a 50% plus, so it takes whatever your full thing is, halves that, and adds it on. So, cool little note there. So this has a little bit more durability than what it would usually have. By the way, with making Tinker's construct stuff, you need aluminum brass to make the... Or I think it's aluminum brass, something, whatever it's called. But to make the castings, you need that. And to make that, it's aluminum and copper. Now, how we get aluminum? There is aluminum gravel here, but there is no aluminum itself in the thing. There is aluminum. It's added by Immersive Engineering, and it's the bauxite ore. This, whenever you throw it into the smeltery, it pretty much converts it, or it is, I don't know what it is, but it pretty much converts it to the aluminum in there. So just an FYI, and you'll see it here soon whenever I start making, which I should start making it. To start with the Tinker's Construct smeltery, you need to make some grout and start cooking that up. Which, now that this is upgraded, this should have upgraded to level mining. Wait. Never mind. It upgraded in skill, didn't upgrade in, which it'll hear soon. Yep, there we go. You needed the mining level up one. So there we go. Now it's mining level copper, which you can tell with the mining level boosted and all that type of stuff. So Now, what I can do is I can mine some coal. And look, we have some things to cook with.
Yes.
I do need food, so let's start cooking that up. That way I don't go hungry. Also, one thing you should do is you should probably grab as much coal as possible. I know it's one of those material things that it just there's so much of it, and you don't really want to use it up. But it is a very valuable resource, although there is a lot of it. It is a valuable resource, and I would grab pretty much whatever materials you have in the pack you need to grab whenever you see it. So just a little quick note there. Just grab it. Even if you get a lot of it, it will be used whenever possible. So grab it or else. All right, there we go. There's that. I think it might have, maybe not. And we have some copper here. Copper is good for the beginning, so also grab that. All right. That's a nice bit of copper, too. There we go. So great. Yay. And also the aluminum. Grab that. And then we are getting ready. Whoops. Hello. I need to make a chest, don't I? Let's make two of them. All right. There's that. Oops. I'll just throw that in there for now. And let's add them right here. I'll deal with the other stuff later. I need to go grab the... I'm going to be cleaning this up... cleaning this area up later, so don't worry about it. All right, there's that. And we want to throw you in there so we can... oh, hello. That's a nice bit of saturation there. Yeah. I'll take that. All right, there we go. That sounded very weird. All right, so we want to cook up as much as we can of the grout so we can start making the Tinker's smeltery. So whenever possible, start smelting that up so you can make the smeltery whenever you need it to be. All right, I'm going to... I don't know how far I want this to go, but this is going to take some time to be able to mine up and stuff. People are so loud downstairs. So annoying. I want to get a studio so I don't have to bother with hearing people. And if I do hear people, it should be me friends. All right, there we go. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Seriously. Why are people so loud? All right, anyways, I'm going to let some of that smelt up. I'm going to mine and then... I guess we'll get back with that, and hopefully people quit yelling. So, I'll see you in a moment. Okay, I got some things mined down, and I've got pretty much my centralized area that I'm going to be working in for the most part at the beginning, and also like a little part here that I'm going to be setting up my beginner smeltery. I'll be moving it, but this is just to kind of get the tools and stuff ready for the kind of overhaul of everything going to be happening. All right, there we go. That should be good. So one thing you'll need right now is your book and however many seared bricks that you did. Now, for the beginning here, the only way to be able to progress is, of course, with the progression book. And you can look in here to seeing what all you can accomplish, which I'm not sure. You have to double click for it to go. Oh, wait. Okay. I totally forgot how this thing works. Oh my goodness. Okay. So the green ones is the things that are unlockable. Now these you can't unlock until they be highlighted green like this. And then the ones that you've already unlocked, they're going to be orange like this. So this needed seared bricks, only one of them, but I do have almost a stack. But you only need one to unlock it. And now once we got this, now we're able to make all this type of stuff. Which you need the seared brick anyways to make that. So at the beginning, you won't be able to make any of this type of stuff until you get the things, but that's all right. So to get this, you have to get some clay, it looks like, which won't be too hard. If we just, let's grab, is that all the coal we had? Oh, wow. Okay, well, I'll just take a few of you. And let's grab you, and we're going to need a whole bunch of clay, well, we're going to need a bunch of bricks anyways because of the coke oven that we'll be making probably next episode. Because this one's kind of boiling down to just getting the smeltery going and trying to get some more basic tools running. Also, water sources will be good. I need to make that anyways so I can... actually, I forget. Does it... I think you have to make it from this, possibly. Yeah, okay. So you need to get this first off. And I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself, but I will need that. And I need this. That doesn't unlock anything, though. All right, so what we're going to want for the smeltery to begin with, we need the controller, which this will get you a book anyways. We're going to need the tank, which is a piece of glass inside of this. There we go. We're going to need a casting table. You can get a basin, but I would wait for that right now because the only time you really use the basin is for blocks, and that's only for big just throwing things in at. And then once you get a kind of progressed machinery and stuff, you don't really use a basin, so I would just kind of not get it. You'll need a drain, a faucet, and a drain. And that's basically all you need for those blocks, and then you need to grab a few seared bricks. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to get the base of this and put it right there. Let me get a few cobblestone here. Also, one thing I was going to do... And I still need, can I make seeds from this? Yes, I can. You will be helpful later on. But what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to make a pressure plate, and some of you should know what I'm making. Can I make a juicer? I forget. Can I make a juicer in this? Oh, yeah. Whoop. Wait. Wait a minute. Why is that? It's probably because, yeah, it's right here. Which means I need to get you. Let's do this really quickly because I'm going to need food here soon anyways. Well, there's a lot of things that you need to accomplish at the beginning, and it just... you tend to have to multitask as you go along in this thing. So let's get this unlocked, and that'll let us get this, which I'm not... I forget. What do you need for this? That's an iron ingot, which we'll be getting here soon anyways because we need upgrade from flint to iron. Actually... I think it's iron. It may be copper, but I think it's iron. There we go. There's that. All right. And then we can do that once we get some iron, which I will be getting iron here soon because I need a bucket anyways. So there we go. All right. There's that. Now that that's out of the way, I need to... Let's put you up for a second. That way I don't accidentally place you. All right. Let's grab you and some of you guys. All right. So... What we're going to want is we're going to want the controller in the front. I usually put the tank over here and the drain over here. Make sure the circle thingy bobber is on the outside because it takes whatever from inside. This is basically the bigger one and then it pours out and you need the faucet right there and put the casting table right there. And then to finish off the very beginning one you just place there, and this will activate the thing. But to be able to cook anything in here, you need lava, or if you can get liquid pyrothium, that also you can also throw that in there, and that cooks faster too, but that's for a later thing. And to get it, you can only place one block in here and it fills this up pretty fast, so to get it higher you can just place a few more in there. I need one more block, and then it just, depending on how many open air blocks you have inside of it, is depending on how big the selections are for putting in the ores. So just be aware of that. I'm making more glass anyways because we're gonna need it. Also, let's grab you to unlock whatever it was, coke oven. Unlock, please. There we go. Takes a little bit of time, but it's right. And then to get into steel production and stuff, we're going to need to also grit. I think grit is one of the things I'm pretty sure we can do that right now. Well, once I get the hammer at least. But beforehand, it kind of changed. So I guess we'll find out here pretty soon. But to get the hammer, we're going to need... okay, there it is. To get the hammer, we're going to need two iron ingots and a piece of string. So that's going to go pretty well. I'm going to keep that in my inventory for... Actually, I might as well just chuck you. All right. So what I need to do now is I need to go mining at the moment. Because what I need to do is I need to find some iron and also lava. I need to find lava first. That's lovely. Let's not fall down there at the moment. I need to grab some ladders, and we are going to take a little nice trip downstairs. Because what I need to do is I need to find some lava, and usually what I do is I just make a nice little mine shaft down. Please. Okay. One thing that'll be, I should do is get some torches down here. Can I find, whoops, hello. That's a side issue. Wait. We really don't need one, frankly, right there. Okay. There we go. There's that. It's gonna be a little bit dark. Let's see if we can find some coal. Which, hello. Oh, it's a bat. Ooh. Also, by the way, guys, I upgraded this again with a skill, and I got some luck. So, you can now possibly get some extra stuff from doing that. So, that's pretty cool. Let's grab some of you. Let's also grab some of flint. There we go. And I'm going to do a little mining expedition so I can hopefully find some lava and grab that. And then that way we can start going into some making tools. So I'll see you in a moment. Man, one thing I hate is those skeletons. They hurt so much. All right, so I went a bit down from the cave here and I have found at least one lava fall thing here, which is okay. That's pretty much all I need at the very beginning. So let's grab that and let's hurry on up. Now, as I said, I don't usually make, oh, that's a zombie. That's, I don't want to deal with that at the moment, but I don't usually make a sword at all. And usually at the beginning, what I do is I use a hatchet or axe, whatever you want to call it. How did I get back? How do I get back? Oh yeah, it's up here. This is a nice little cave, though, for getting some resources at the beginning, which is going to be nice. But once I get pretty much all this excavated out, I will block this off and then make a tunnel straight down. Well, not straight down, but a staircase straight down to level 10 or 11. I usually do it around 11, so I can mine for some pretty good diamonds. Are you in my house? You just sounded really loud. All right. So we knew there. All right, so that's going to destroy the clay bucket. Clay bucket. Whoa, words. If you use it with water, it's going to also. Oh yeah, I need to upgrade my tool to copper before I can do anything. But with that, let's start getting you smelted first off. But with that, I. With the clay bucket, if I remember what I'm saying, if you're using it for water, it will never be destroyed. But since it's clay, if you use it with lava, it's only a single-use thing. So it's good for just getting the beginning of this going, and also skyblock. By the way, guys, with the skyblock thing, I was going to say this at the beginning of the video, but if I may end up doing a collab with Dreamy, but if I don't end up doing a collab with Dreamy, I'm not going to continue the Project Ozone series. But what I am going to do, I like doing skyblocks because starting from nothing, basically, and getting into huge things, I like the concept of that. The thing is that I don't like the way Project Ozone is designed. It's a little chaotic, and it's not my cup of tea. But what I am going to do is it looks like they have officially launched out the FTB Infinity Skyblock. And that's basically kind of like the expert mode that I've been playing, but Skyblock version. So I think I'm going to start playing that. I'm going to mess around with it in some live streams and see how well it goes before I actually start making a series, because that's kind of what's been happening. The reason why I hated trying to do series is because I tried to start the series before I even know what it's going to be about, and it just kind of ends up horribly. But I'm going to mess around with it probably in some live streams, see if I like it. And if I really do like it, then I will mess around with it while doing some other things. All right, so this should get me at least... okay, so this, the Tinkers, what you should probably do is when you get the... whenever you get the hammer, hopefully you can make it grits. And you should probably try to get the grits and then throw it in here, or else this is only going to give you one per thing, and it's not going to go well. But this at least gets me to one ingot, which is good. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to get the... I left it up there. We're going to want to grab... I'll just leave it up here for now. But we're going to want to grab the pickaxe out of this, put it in here, and grab this. Voila. And we're going to make our first upgraded, tier 2 upgrade of the pickaxe, which is nice. So make sure that's there. Let's make the cast. It'll disappear from that. One thing I like about Iguana Twix is that it uses the thing and destroys it, making it to where I don't have to destroy it. Anyways, that's going to do that. Pour it in. And we have ourselves a copper pickaxe. This is the first time upgrading the thing, and you can continually upgrade it as high as you need it to be. But usually once I hit Alumite, I usually make the full... actually, if I can find a slimy tool, we'll talk about that in the next episode. But usually I make a new whole new tool itself whenever I get to Alumite. Anyways, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to grab some gravel. And the only way to be able to upgrade tools is to, at least in this version, is to have it fully repaired, have no damage, go into your tool station, which I need to bring this down here soon. Once I get a place there, it'll be nice. Throw that right here and put that where your pickaxe is, and there you go. You have yourself a next upgrade pickaxe. And what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to mine. As you can tell, with the mining XP, it reset. And what this is going to do is it's going to upgrade again up to the next mining level, which makes it iron. So let's go mine a little bit. Why not? You know, I think what I'm going to do is actually... Yeah, I'm going to go this way, away from my base, just in case. Totally did not mean to rhyme there. Sorry. but basically, I need to mine a little bit. That way I can get it upgraded again so I can mine some iron. And we can get going with some food, some extra tools. There we go. That upgrades it to boosted to iron. And now, guess what we can do? If I can find it. We can mine. That's copper. Where are you when I need you? We can mine some iron. So amazing. There is no point of throwing, unless if you want to make the pickaxe out of it. There's no point of actually... Hey, there's some more lava. Not exactly how I wanted to find it, though. Whoops. Where's the hole? It's right here. Alright. I hear an enderman. I don't really have a use for you, buddy. Sorry. Sorry. Why am I saying sorry to you? You're staying alive. Alright, there we go. There's a few iron. I don't need to grab that many at the moment. Do we need an enderpearl? I'm not going to do that because I'm probably going to die if I try to do that. Let's stay alive as long as possible. Alright, so now what we can do is I'm not going to smelt it up with the smeltery because, frankly, that'll be a waste. But what I am going to do is I need 5 of them, at least at the moment. I'm going to start cooking you up, and we are going to, hopefully it's dark outside, because I need to find some spider. Oh, it's not dark. Of course it isn't dark. Why would you be dark? Alright, you know what I should do is I should just find some textile gardens. What that is basically cotton. And that'll let us grow some of that. Either that or actually what we should probably just find is because we'll need this, is the, I think it's flax is what it's called, or hemp, whatever it's called, but from the industrial. And how you get that is just breaking these. I also need to, some point in time, get some shears so I can grab the vines for some stuff. That's carrots. That's great. There we go. That's what I wanted. Some industrial hemp seeds. And basically what this is going to do is it's going to grow a too tall tree. And don't destroy the whole tree. Plant. Sorry, guys. Don't destroy the whole plant. Just hit the top and it will throw out some seeds and throw out some industrial string. And industrial string will be used for making windmills and I think maybe other stuff, I'm not too sure. But also you can convert the industrial string into regular string. So that's the use of that. Alright, let's eat some stuff. And the reason why I'm coming back in here is because I need to make a mattock. Alright, let's grab six of you. Because I'm going to need to make another shovel and axe head. The reason for that is because that's the ingredients to make the mattocks. The mattocks? The mattock. Whatever. I don't know how to speak today. Alright, so mattock, and this is going to act. You can use this as a shovel, you can use this as an axe, and you can also use it as a hoe. And the reason why I like this is because you can repair it and you don't have to constantly keep remaking a hoe. So, nice tool tip for today. Tool tip, something, whatever. And we have some cool little water over here, which is nice. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to plant two of for now. We do have some bones from killing some skeletons. And I'm just going to, boom. And yeah, just whatever. What did I just unlock? I'm not too sure. Steel production. This. That's the wrong thing. Okay. Creator, modpack creator, what's going on? I don't understand. Alright, so basically what you can do with this is you can put it in the thing and it converts into string. Nice little tip there. Instead of having to get out of here. Also, this has really good attack damage, just letting you know. Just FYI. Alright, so now what we can do is, now that that is made up, oh yeah, also we can now make, possibly, I need to make you, which means I need these two. There we go. And now I can make the juicer, which now allows me to juice all of those, which now puts it up to 1.5 instead of half. And it has a lot of saturation, which is great. But there we go. Perfect all. Alright, now what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to make one, a bucket, and two, the hammer. Grit. And also apparently this. Oh yeah, okay. Cool. And well, hopefully, I'm not too sure on if this is if this works. But you should be able to wait. I totally forgot. This thing, there's a little consume thing here. If this is true, it'll consume the item that you make, which is a little bit annoying. So we have to remake that. I'll just cook all that up. So, yeah, that's fairly annoying. But yes, well guys, I'm going to try it on copper really quickly, but I hope you guys enjoyed this. Hit the like button if you did. Comment down below with some tips, tricks, and other things to help people out. And subscribe for more content. We're going to have some more things. Also, watch out for the skeletons that have special bows because, as you can tell, some things have other things and... That just scared the crap out of me. I thought it was a creeper. Let's block you off for now. Thanks for interrupting my outro. But anyway, guys, subscribe for more content. We're going to have some more things coming through. Hey, we got Starter's Quartz from something. Did that destroy something? Maybe it just destroyed a block. That's nice if it did. But anyways. Alright, let's check this out. Can we... you may have to be able to do it with a full block here. Can we? No, we cannot. It does not work with full things, so I'll have to figure out another way to double ore very quickly. Anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, comment down below with stuff and like the thing and rate it if you want. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this. It is a upgraded kind of series because all the older ones have some crappy editing and stuff, but now I've been editing better and bigger. Yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll be seeing you guys in another video / series. Hope you guys enjoyed this. I'll be seeing you guys next time. Goodbye. Come on.